Some relief in our Delta outbreak tonight with news that the toughest COVID restrictions will soon be eased for most of the country. Cabinet deciding all of New Zealand south of Auckland will move to alert level 3 from 11:59pm on Tuesday. Auckland and Northland remain at the highest alert level, with Cabinet reviewing that on Monday. But the Prime Minister indicated Tāmaki Makaurau will likely stay in level 4 for another 2 weeks. The latest numbers, and there are 70 new cases today, all in Auckland, with the outbreak total now 347. 19 people are receiving hospital care. One is stable in ICU. Nearly 30,000 individual contacts have been identified, with 76% tested. We have team coverage for you this evening and start with Donna Marie Lever in Christchurch. What's the reaction there, Donna Marie?
Good evening. Well, there's been a real mixed reaction, because level 3 is really good for some people and businesses and it simply doesn't work for others. And then there's the question of wastewater. We know that COVID-19 has been again detected in Christchurch's wastewater, but we also know there are 3 cases in managed isolation here, and further rigorous testing will be carried out. That could really prove crucial, as the Prime Minister has said, that any case or cluster detected in the South Island could really take that offer of level 3 off the table. But I think for now, most in the South are looking forward to some sort of sense of freedom. This will soon be a sign of the past as the South is set to reopen.
It'll be good. I have to go back to work and, get amongst everything.
You can go to McDonald's.
I can't remember exactly what the rules are for 3.
There have been no community cases in the entire South Island since November last year, 297 days ago.
Cabinet has decided that all of New Zealand south of the Auckland boundary will move to level 3 at 11:59pm on Tuesday, August 31.
Coming out of alert levels is tough, because then you are dealing with risk, and there is no right answer. There's no level of risk that is acceptable to everyone.
For the Collis family in Ashburton, their bubble is about to get bigger.
So we've got my husband's parents living in town, so they're in their 70s, so we'll go around and make sure that they're okay.
But the pressure of home learning remains.
My husband will probably go back to the office, which will leave me home alone with the kids. So that'll be fun, and I'm working as well.
Baristas in the South are braced, hoping business will be busy.
We've had level 3 for quite a while before, and a lot of our members were very innovative and did all sorts of things to get some dollars coming in the door.
But at the Edgewater Hotel in Wanaka, level 3 makes little difference.
We can't open to the public. Whilst businesses in town can for takeaways, it's still going to be... We're still going to be closed, basically, and it's really tough.
And she's not alone wanting more freedom.
Level 2 would be better.
One better still.
Ski fields in the south are running out of snow and the season, and can't operate until level 2.
Ski conditions in spring can be amazing, and we want to make sure that people get the chance to participate if they can.
But the small luxuries of level 3 will be on hold for a little longer. It's not official until midnight Tuesday. Donna Marie Lever, One News.
And the upcoming easing of restrictions also means many businesses and industries in the lower North Island are now preparing to kick back into action next week. Our Hawke's Bay reporter Sean Hogan joins us now. And a big boost for the local economy expected, Sean.
Yeah, that's right, Simon. Those retail and hospitality business will receive a welcome boost if we go down to level 3. But so too will the massive forestry industry. The $6.7 billion export earner for our country will be able to operate in level 3, and it's an industry the East Coast relies heavily on. Unlike last lockdown, though, the demand for logs from overseas has been ongoing. So businesses have been missing out on millions of dollars worth of turnover. The industry told me today that if there was to be an extension of the lockdown, there is likely to be layoffs in the industry, as some businesses are just holding on.
I've been loading boats now, so the port's empty, and I think there'll be boats out in the bay now that will be waiting for loads. So we'll be desperate to get back to work and get into it.
Now, the industry wants to open up a conversation with the government about being able to operate in Level 4. It believes because of the mechanisation it's done in the industry and the spacious outdoor environment that it operates in, it believes that it could safely operate in Level 4 if another lockdown is needed.
Ngā mihi, Sean, in Heratonga, Hastings. Sean Hogan. All right, let's bring in political reporter Benedict Collins for some analysis on the decision. And politically speaking, Benedict, the announcement today buying the government some time.
Yeah, that's right. I think what the government's done today basically is hit the pause button. It's bought itself a few more days just to make absolutely sure that there are no unknown cases that we don't know about yet with COVID-19 around the country. We do know there were lots of people in Auckland at the start of this outbreak at those locations of interest who then spread out throughout New Zealand. They just want to make absolutely sure there aren't any more cases. But if some unexpected cases do pop up over the weekend, I think we'll all be waiting a bit longer for those takeaway coffees and KFC. Look, the government had been hoping to move the rest of New Zealand down today, but I think they were a little bit too optimistic. Once those cases started popping up in Wellington, and also those wastewater test results in Christchurch, simply meant it wasn't safe to move the country down yet. And I think it's fair to say the government has been somewhat startled by just how rapidly this Delta outbreak has ballooned.
Kia ora, Benedict. Thank you for that. At Paramatta Parliament, political reporter Benedict Collins.